Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to talk about that is how does the beryllium is behaving different from that of the other elements, as well as we also discussed about the different uses of the alkaline earth metals. But now we are going to talk about the diagonal relationship between that is beryllium and aluminium. So how they are very much related to each other, even though they are of different block, that is beryllium is belonging to S block while the aluminium is belonging to P block. So even though being divided into two different groups or two different blocks in the periodic table, they have a similar property. So what are those? Let me talk about that. So talking about the first point, that is the beryllium and aluminium have strong tendency to form covalent compounds. So suppose if I talk about the beryllium, and we have discussed earlier also that is the beryllium is the one which is less electropositive, and that's the reason that it forms a covalent bond with any other atom or any other group to which it has been forming a bond, and that's the reason it forms a covalent compound, while the rest of the group 2 elements except beryllium, they form ionic compounds. So this is what beryllium is different from that of the other elements belonging to the same group. But meanwhile, it is also very much relatable to that of the aluminium, because aluminium also forms a covalent bond whenever it has been combined with that of the other groups or other elements. So this was the first point, and now let us talk about the next one, that is beryllium and aluminium do not react with acid. Yes, as we have discussed earlier also, that is beryllium is the one that does not react with that of the acid. Meanwhile, even aluminium has the same condition. The reason behind that is because they forms the oxide layer on the metal. So for example, if I talk about the beryllium, so beryllium also has an oxide layer on it, and that's the reason it is not that much reactive with that of the acid. So similarly, it is applicable to aluminium also. While the rest of the elements, like suppose if I'm talking about the alkaline earth metals like magnesium, even magnesium has an oxide layer on it, that is magnesium oxide, but we have to give a certain kind of temperature, or we have to heat it so as the reaction would happen, and that's the reason that the magnesium can be easily reacted with that of the acid. But meanwhile, talk about the beryllium, that doesn't react too much easily with that of the acid. And now let us move on to the next one, and that is beryllium hydroxide, when dissolved in basically alkali solution, so therefore they will form that is beryllate ion. So therefore this is the ion that I am talking about, that is it consists of 2 minus charge and it forms a complex. So similarly, it is also applicable for the aluminium. Whenever the aluminium is been or aluminium hydroxide is been dissolved in an alkali, it forms an aluminate ion, and the only the formula would be changed. So therefore here it will be AlOH4 and this will be 2 minus. So they have basically kind of same property, and this is what I was talking about. And now there are also further points that I'm going to discuss about, and those are, so talking about the fourth point, that is whenever the beryllium carbide that has been represented with the molecular formula that is Be2C, and aluminium carbide that is Al4C3, whenever they get hydrolyzed, so they forms methane. So it is not applicable for any other that is elements belonging to the same group. Like suppose if I'm talking about group 2 elements, if I'm talking about calcium carbide, when react with it is reacted with that of water or on hydrolysis, it doesn't produce methane. In fact, it gives us an ethyne. So this is what we have discussed in the chapter, that is alkynes also. So this is what I want to talk about, and that is how the beryllium is comparatively different from that of the other elements belonging to the same group, and somewhere it is very much similar to that of the aluminium, which is belonging to P block. So yeah, let me discuss about the reaction that takes place over here. That is whenever the beryllium carbide is been reacted with that of 4 moles of H2, that is it undergoes hydrolysis, so as to form that is beryllium hydroxide along with that of the methane molecule. So this methane molecule is also liberated during this reaction. So whenever the aluminium carbide is also been reacted or with that of the water molecule, that is whenever it undergoes hydrolysis, it forms aluminium hydroxide along with that of liberation of that is CH4. So somewhere we could find that the similarities is between these two groups, or these two like aluminium and beryllium. So these are the chemical properties which they have been very much similar. So let me discuss about the next point, that is whenever beryllium chloride and AlCl3, so they are acting like an Lewis acid, so therefore they could be easily reacted with the base. So but talking about this Lewis acid like AlCl3, this is very much applicable in Friedel-Crafts reaction. and that's a very much important role of the AlCl3, that it gives a kind of substitution reaction, that is Friedel-Crafts alkylation or Friedel-Crafts acylation. So these are the similarities between BCl2 and AlCl3. And now let me discuss about the other similarities also, and that is what we have discussed earlier also, and that is whenever we are talking about the hydroxides, that is beryllium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide. So as we have discussed earlier, that is beryllium hydroxide is not basic in nature, in fact it is amphoteric in nature. So similarly, even aluminium hydroxide, that is AlOH thrice, is basically amphoteric in nature, while the others, if we are talking about the other elements of the group 2 except beryllium, so the other hydroxides that are being formed with the group 2 elements, they are basically basic in nature. So that how it has been different. So and somewhere it is similar to beryllium and aluminium, they have the similar properties. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know the concept behind the similarities between the beryllium and aluminium through a diagonal relationship. And I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.